Welcome everyone to my part two of the video on the possible combinations for doing a business or a job. As you all know that I had made a previous video in which I had told you about certain combinations, certain things in your horoscope, which will help you guess the right profession for you. Many of you were able to join the dots and figure out the right profession that is meant for you. But dear friends, many of you also had certain confusions because the combinations which I gave you were not complete in themselves because they need more clarification, which I am going to clarify through this video of mine with the help of further more points and more examples. So without delaying further, I would request you to bring your notebooks and start taking notes and try to understand what are the further combinations which are needed to understand how to distinguish between a businessman or a person who is going to be into a job. So I am going to put the screen on share, and this is a small presentation which I have saved in the PDF format which I had made for you. So I will just explain this to you. So friends, the first point is, if you take a horoscope irrespective of the ascendant and you draw an imaginary line from the center of the first house up till the center of the seventh house, and you see that majority of your planets are falling in this axis towards the right hand side of your horoscope. So that shows that the person is well suited to do a business. Now, sometimes this combination may be there in certain charts and they are not doing businesses, they are doing jobs. So what are those points? I will tell you after this. So the second point is, if majority of your planets, if you draw a imaginary line from the center of the fourth house up till the center of your 10th house, and majority of your planets are falling above this line, it means that you are well suited to do a business. But again, despite having this, you could be doing a job. So what are those points which are needed additionally? So friends, this combination can also give you a business and this combination can also give you a job. So additional point for doing a job is that if your Saturn or your Trik Lords, that is 6th Lord, 8th Lord or the 12th Lords, if the Trik Lords or Saturn makes a combination with your 10th Lord, 10th House or with Moon, then it means that you are well suited to do a business, then it means that you are well suited to do a job which is going to be like a business, because the planets are here, which shows that the person is going to do a business or going to have an independent profession. But if you are Saturn or 6, 8, 12 Lords make a connection with the 10th house, 10th Lord or with Moon, then despite having this combination, you will be doing a job. If you have this combination and in this, if three or more planets, that is four planets, that is Puran Paramatmash, Sun, Moon, Mars, Rahu, if at least three of them are falling in this axis or in this axis, then it means that the person shall be doing a business. Also, if your ascendant Lord is very strong, then also the person is going to do a business along with Puran Paramatmash planets falling in this side of the axis. At least three of them should be there. So having a strong ascendant will make you an industrialist and a very good businessman. And Puran Paramatmash planets should also fall either in this axis or in this axis. So there should be three or even four of them. So this is the other point. So there is one more point which I did not discuss. So the third point is that if you happen to see the nakshatras of the planets, if at least five of these nakshatras, I mean to say, if five planets fall in the nakshatra of Puran Paramatmash planets, For example, suppose your Jupiter's nakshatra is Rahu and your Venus's nakshatra is Mars and your Mercury's nakshatra is Sun. It could be any of the Puran Paramatmish nakshatra. Then it means that you shall be well suited to do a business because the planets, they are going to be eventually directed by the kind of nakshatras they fall into. So at least 5 of the nakshatras should belong to the Puran Paramatmansh nakshatras. If this combination is not there and still you are keen to do business, then it means you may have majority of your planets falling in the fiery signs or in the airy signs. So if majority of the planets, they fall in the fiery, that is 1, 5, 9 signs, or in the airy signs, that is 3, 7, 11. That is also a very good combination for doing a business. So 5 or more planets should be in the airy or in the fiery signs. That is also a good combination to do a business. So friends, let's see the first example. This is the same example which I had given in one of my previous videos. This is the chart of a person who is doing a military job. So let's see. So see here, majority of the planets 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, they fall above this axis, even moon. So 7 planets are falling in this axis. So it means that the person is well suited to do a business, but this person is doing a military job, which is a service. So why is it so? As I had told you, Saturn should connect with the moon. So here Saturn is aspecting planet moon, and also Saturn is aspecting the 10th lord, that is Sun. This is the point I told you will be there in the charts of those people who are into jobs. Another point that I told you, the trick lords, that is 6, 8 and 12. So here 6th lord cannot be considered as the trick lord because it is also the ascendant lord. So let's ignore this for a while. And here the 8th lord is Mercury. So Mercury is also connecting with the 10th lord Sun. So this is a very clear indication that the person shall be in a very good job, which is going to be high paying, because the planets also show a business. So business will always give you more income. So it means the person will be in a well-placed job because Sun, that is the 10th lord, makes a connection with one of the trick lords, and Saturn makes a connection with the Sun and with the moon. So this shows that the person is going to do a job. Let's look at the nakshatras. So Sun is in the nakshatra of Mercury. So let's directly count the Puran Paramatmansh nakshatras. This is Mars 1 and 2. Only 2 Puran Paramatmansh nakshatras are there. And here also you will see that majority of the planets are in here Jupiter and Rahu are in the fiery sign, and Venus and Mars are in the airy signs, and Ketu is in the airy signs. So at least 5 planets are in the category of the business signs. So it means that post retirement, this person can think of doing a business, because although the nakshatras are showing job, but the placement of the planets, they show that the person could also do a business sometimes later in his life. But majority of the combinations are indicating that the person should be doing a job only. So let's look at the other example. This is the same example which I had discussed in one of my previous videos of an IPS officer. So here, majority of the planets are falling on the right side, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So 5 planets, they fall on the right side, which shows that the person is suited to do a business, but this person is also into a service. Why is it so? Because Saturn is connecting with Moon. This is the important criteria for doing a job. And also, Moon is the 10th Lord. So this is also another combination which is there. Saturn is connecting with Moon also and with the 10th Lord, which is again Moon. And here the Trick Lord, that is Jupiter, is also aspecting the 10th Lord Moon, which is a very strong combination for doing a job. So all the combinations are indicating towards doing a job. Now let's look at the Puran Paramatmansh Nakshatras here. So here, one, Sun is the Puran Paramatmansh, Moon is the Puran Paramatmansh. Only two nakshatras are in the Puran Paramatmansh category. So that is a clear indication that the job is very well suited to this person. And here if we look at the placement, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six planets are in the fiery signs. So it means that the person may desire to do a business, but majority of the combination is pointing towards a job. So it means that the person would be doing a job only. So let's look at the third example. This is the example of Mr. Amitabh Bachchan. So in the example, a majority of the planets are again on the right hand side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So they fall on the right hand side of the imaginary axis that we make from the first house up till the seventh house. So five planets are here. It shows that the person is well suited to do his own work. But is Saturn making a connection with the 10th house? Yes, Saturn is aspecting the 10th house, and through its retro aspect, it is also aspecting the Moon. So it means that the person should be doing a job. He should be well placed in a job. Now, here we are getting mixed indications. So to clarify our doubts, we will move to the nakshatras. So let's see the Puran Paramatmansh nakshatras here. Rahu, Moon, Moon, Mars, Rahu, Mars. Majority of the nakshatras, they fall in the Puran Paramatmansh category. So it means that the person is well suited to do a business. So here, planets are also in the Ketu is in the fiery sign, Moon is in the airy sign, and Rahu is in the fiery sign. So here it shows that the person is more suited to do a business, because majority of the nakshatras they fall in the Puran Paramatmansh category. And because Saturn is making a connection with the 10th house and with Moon, so it shows that his business could be job-like. So actors, they have to work like a job only. So you can call it a business which is job-like. So they have to report at the place of their shooting every day, and they have to be present there on time. So it's a kind of business which is job-like. So that is how we are able to connect. So here, majority of the nakshatras are in the Puran Paramatmansh category, and Saturn making a connection with the 10th house and with Moon shows that the person could be into a business-like job. Now let's look at the other example, which is of a businessman. So this businessman, let's see. Majority of the planets are on the right-hand side. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Mercury, Jupiter, Moon, and Ketu. And this side only 4 are falling. But if we draw a line from the center of the 4th house up till the 10th house, then we will see Mercury, Sun, Venus, Rahu, Mars, and even Saturn. So they fall on the above axis. Horizontal axis above the 10th house and the 4th house. So this shows that the person is capable of doing a business. But let's see what is Saturn doing here. Saturn is connecting with the 10th house. This shows that the person can do a job. and Saturn is not connecting with the moon, but Saturn is also connecting with Venus. So this shows that the person can do a job. But now here we are getting mixed indications. The placement shows that the person can do a business, and Saturn's connection with the 10th house and 10th lord shows that the person would be doing a job. Now this will be clarified through the nakshatras here. So Rahu, Moon, Rahu, Mars and Moon. Majority of the nakshatras are in the Puran Paramatmansh category. And here Mercury, Rahu, Saturn and Ketu and Jupiter. And majority of the planets are also in the fiery or airy signs. So this is again a clear cut indication that the person is more inclined to do a business rather than doing a job. But the business could be like a job only. So where he has to be very regular, he cannot take chances because Saturn is also connecting with the 10th house. So it's a regular kind of work that he will have to do, but it is basically a business. So friends, I hope with the help of all these examples, your doubts must have cleared. So try to apply these points which I have told you in this video and see if they are going with your horoscope or not. And please do share your comments in the comment box, and I will definitely reply to the relevant comments where I feel that the person is really having a doubt. So I want to thank you all for listening, and I will bring up some more interesting videos in future. And stay connected. Thank you, friends.